Vapor Compression Refrigeration System. In this video, we will understand how simple vapor compression refrigeration systems work. What is refrigeration? Refrigeration is the process of removing the heat from the enclosed system and discharging it to the surrounding and maintaining the space at a temperature lower than the surrounding temperature. A substance that flows through the refrigeration system, acting as a medium which absorbs heat from the evaporator at low pressure and temperature by evaporation, and carries it to the condenser, where it discharges the heat to the surrounding at higher temperature and pressure, is called refrigerant. Essential components of the vapor compression refrigeration system are: compressor, condenser, throttling device, and evaporator. There are four steps involved in this process. Those are: compression, condensation, throttling, evaporation. If you are enjoying this video, please give this video a thumbs up, and if you are new to ADTW Learn, click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification to get more informative videos like this. Compression. The refrigerant enters the compressor at low temperature and low pressure. The refrigerant entering the compressor is in a gaseous state. The function of the compressor is to increase the pressure and temperature of the refrigerant entering. The refrigerant leaving the compressor, having high temperature and pressure, this high-temperature, high-pressure refrigerant enters the condenser. Therefore, we call this isentropic compression process. Condensation. Condensation of refrigerant coming from the compressor carried by the condenser. The condenser is essentially a heat exchanger which rejects the heat to the atmosphere. The rejection of heat can be direct to the air through fins. Another way is that using water-cooled condensers, which have a cooling water supply, whose function is to carry the heat from the condenser to the cooling tower, where further it discharges to the atmosphere. The use of a type of condenser depends on the size of the vapor compression refrigeration system. The refrigerant flowing through the condenser is in constant pressure. Therefore, we call this process isobaric heat rejection process. Throttling and expansion. When the refrigerant enters the throttling valve, it expands, also its pressure reduces. As a result, the temperature drops at this stage. Because of these changes, the refrigerant leaves the throttling valve as a liquid vapor mixture. Here, the throttling valve plays two essential roles. First, it maintains a pressure difference between low and high pressure sides. Second, it controls the amount of liquid refrigerant entering the evaporator. This step is called isenthalpic expansion. Normally, a thermostatic expansion valve is used. These valves have a bulb that will sense the temperature of the refrigerant coming out from the evaporator coil, thus adjusting the amount of refrigerant passing through the expansion device. Evaporation. The refrigerant entering the evaporator is at a lower temperature than the space to be cooled. Therefore, it evaporates and absorbs heat from the closed chamber inside which the evaporator coil is placed. Heat extraction from the space happens at low pressure and temperature. The compressor suction effect helps in maintaining the low pressure at the evaporator side. This step is called isobaric heat extraction. Apart from these essential elements, there are additional components like fan. A fan blows air on the evaporator coil. Air passing over the evaporator coil loses heat to the evaporator coil. These four steps repeat to maintain the space at a lower temperature than the surrounding temperature. This is how a simple vapor compression refrigeration system works. To measure the performance of the refrigeration system, we use COP, which means coefficient of performance. What is coefficient of performance? Coefficient of performance is defined as the heat removed from the cold space divided by the work done to remove the heat from that space. I hope you have understood how VCRS works. It takes lots of effort to make such informative videos. You can help ADTW Learn to make more videos by joining my channel and contributing to developing more such videos. Your support will help me to make more educational videos. Another way of helping my effort is by sharing my videos with your friends. Thank you.